few words elicit the instant intrigue among firearms enthusiasts, says two-digit 1911. Such early production models are truly the beginning of an icon. The pistol was not only a watershed moment in firearms development, but also marked a long and proud history as a standard issue sidearm for the United States. But even the immense significance of the Browning-designed Colt M1911 is magnified when such ridiculously low serial numbers are mentioned. People want to be in its presence, they want to see it, and then they want to tell their friends they saw it. They want to compare it against other such rarities in the firearms world, because that's what we do, right? Well, friends, I'm here to tell you, there is no comparison. Colt model 1911, serial number 81, is the finest two-digit we have offered to date. It retains 95% of its lustrous, original, high-polished Colt commercial blue finish, the type only found on model 1911s made before serial number 2400. The small parts practically glow in the dark with 97% of the original niter blue finish. It bears the correct large font United States property marking on the frame, a font discontinued shortly thereafter this pistol on serial number 83. Keen-eyed and detail-oriented collectors will observe the larger-sized hand checkering on the slide stop and safety lock, a practice discontinued after the first 150 pistols. And these are just the tip of the iceberg when describing the condition of this remarkable two-digit Colt. Now, we've already established this Colt already checks numerous boxes required to become a world-class collectible. It's a beloved model, it's an early production example, and it definitely satisfies that oldest mantra of collecting: condition, condition, condition. But the itch of that old gun collector's wish is still crying to be scratched. What's its history? Perhaps more commonly expressed as, if only this gun could talk. I take great pleasure in telling you that this gun can talk, and it has an impressive story to tell. It was once the property of Adjutant General Lutz Wahl. Very few men in the history of the United States military have been in a position to contribute so much to their country as General Wahl. His service record reads like a telephone book of dates, wars, countries, and steadily increasing rank. Born in the Reconstruction era after the Civil War, Wahl attended West Point and graduated in 1891. His first taste of combat was in the Philippines during the Philippine War in 1899, and again in the Moro Rebellion in 1905. It didn't take long for him to make his presence felt, earning an early recommendation for a brevet captain, quote, for gallantry under fire at Guadalupe Ridge and Zapote River. From the Pacific, Wahl's service took him to Texas during the Pancho Villa expedition, when U.S. forces entered Mexico to retaliate against Pancho Villa's forces for their attack on the town of Columbus, New Mexico. Eventually, those forces' main goal became to prevent further raids, and in that end, Wahl was stationed on border control duty at Eagle Pass, Texas, then a border crossing critical to U.S. troops. When the Great War was declared on April 6, 1917, of course, Wahl didn't wait long to get involved. He commanded the 58th Infantry, served as Chief of Operations General Staff's Infantry, and finally commanded the 14th Infantry Brigade in training and in combat operations in France until the end of the war. For his exemplary work in World War I, Wahl received the Distinguished Service Medal, the citation for which reads, for exceptionally meritorious and distinguished services in a position of great responsibility. In command of the 58th Infantry 4th Division, General Wahl demonstrated leadership of a high order, untiring energy, and sound judgment. As Chief of the Operations Section, General Staff, War Department, he displayed rare professional attainments, initiating and developing many valuable ideas in the organization of the Operations Section. As Brigadier General commanding the 14th Infantry Brigade, 7th Division, he again displayed unusual gifts of organization, leadership, and tactical judgment, both during the period of organization and training of his brigade, as well as in combat operations in France. Wahl is clearly the type of man the United States military was fortunate to have in their fold for almost two decades of outstanding military service. The breadth of the conflicts he was involved in is astonishing. From the Philippine-American War to Pancho Villa, and into the fray of the Great War, Wahl was involved in every major conflict the United States entered into for nearly a quarter century. Such a wide range of service could only be eclipsed by the variety of duties he admirably performed during his military career. Offered now by Rock Island Auction Company is General Lutz Wahl's remarkable M1911 pistol, a pistol likely carried by him from his days guarding the U.S. border from Pancho Villa all the way through German-occupied France in the Great War. To this day, it has remained in the Wahl family, making it previously unseen by the collecting fraternity and absolutely fresh. Accompanying this extraordinary pistol are the type of personal accoutrements one would expect coming straight from the family, such as two of Wahl's military portraits, a one-star general's flag, as well as his campaign service medals, including the Spanish War Service Medal, Philippine Campaign Medal, Mexican Border Service Medal, and World War I Victory Medal with its defensive sector bar. This is absolutely everything a gun collector or military enthusiast could ask for. It is American history. It is documented military service. It is fresh, high condition, visually stunning, an iconic sidearm, a classic design, an early production model, and it's definitely a gun with a story to tell. And it's only at Rock Island Auction Company.